good morning. I'm Erin Phalo. This is News 9 Plus on Facebook, X, and YouTube. And at this time tomorrow, voters across the state will be heading to the polls to cast their ballots in New Hampshire's first in the nation primary. The voting starts at midnight in Dixville Notch, continuing a 64-year-old tradition. Six voters will gather in the living room of the Tillotson House to cast their first ballots of the 2024 primary. And those results will immediately be reported across the country. Now that Ron DeSantis has suspended his presidential campaign, only two major candidates remain in the race for the GOP nomination: former President Donald Trump and former UN Ambassador Nikki Haley. Trump will speak in Laconia tonight as he makes his final push to voters. Last night, there was a big turnout for his rally in Rochester. WMUR's Marissa Tanzino got a reaction from voters after Ron DeSantis announced that he's now endorsing Trump.
Well, before they went into this rally here, supporters of the former president told us while they are happy to hear Governor Ron DeSantis dropped out of the race and eventually endorsed the former president, they do believe that the relationship between the two is at the point of no return. Now, a couple of key issues at the top of supporters' minds here: the border and the cost of everything from groceries to gas. Many of his supporters say they aren't happy with the way the current administration has handled issues like the economy and the border crisis, so they are hoping to see change in November.
Don't think this great superpower can die in an instant if the wrong people are in charge, and the wrong people are in charge.
Drill. He's going to drill, and then he's going to close the border.
And some of the people who waited out here all day to get in were also at his rally in Manchester the other night, while there were others who waited out here for hours and ultimately did not get in. In Rochester, Marissa Tanzino, WMUR News 9.
And Nikki Haley will be holding events in Franklin and Salem today. This follows a busy day of campaigning. As WMUR's Ariel Metropolis reports, Haley brought a special guest to her rally in Exeter, Judge Judy.
This is only the second time that Judge Judy has dipped her toes publicly into politics, but earlier this month, she endorsed Nikki Haley. You might remember back in 2020, Judge Judy endorsed Democratic presidential candidate and former New York City Mayor Mike Bloomberg. Judge Judy says she believes Haley is the best choice for this moment, particularly given the fact that she believes former President Trump and President Biden are too old for the job.
Put your money where your mouth is. You got to get up off your behind if you believe that, and travel 1,700 miles if that's what it takes to tell the people of New Hampshire that it's a critical time for them.
And Haley will have another long day of campaigning. She'll finish off her night with another rally in Salem. In Exeter, Ariel Metropolis, WMUR News 9.
More than 80,000 Granite Staters are expected to cast ballots in New Hampshire's Democratic primary tomorrow. Dean Phillips and Marianne Williamson, who are challenging President Biden for the nomination, have been hitting the campaign trail hard in the Granite State. Phillips has stops planned in Manchester and Nashua today, and Williamson is scheduled to make an appearance in Hooksett. Both candidates joined us in our studio yesterday morning for our live hour-long edition of Close Up. Williamson was pressed about a comment that she made regarding not wanting those with fiscal responsibility in her potential cabinet.
What's so bad about fiscal responsibility?
Oh, no. That's out of context. I said, I don't believe that this government should be run like a fiscally responsible business. I said it should be run like a fiscally responsible family. You put your children first, not your corporate profits.
But you did say this. You say, I don't want fiscal responsibility people in my cabinet.
Well, if I said that, that's still, again, a little bit out of context.
Now, Dean Phillips, who also appeared on Close Up, shared his thoughts on the future of artificial intelligence.
This is what's coming. If we don't start having guardrails now, anticipate both the curses, but most importantly, the blessings of how AI can reduce costs and develop better outcomes. I will be an AI president because Donald Trump and Joe Biden do not have the capacity to do it.
President Biden's name will not be on the first in the nation primary ballot, but his supporters are running a write-in campaign. Election officials will have to hand count those write-in ballots, but Secretary of State David Scanlon says that he still expects to have the full results on election night. WMUR is your home for everything primary. Join us tonight at 10 p.m. for our primary special, The Final Hours. At 11, we'll have a special edition of News 9 Tonight, and we will stay on the air as the first votes are cast at midnight in Dixville Notch. Well, turning now to the forecast as we take a live look at the big lake there in Meredith. It is very chilly out there in many areas. It's in the teens and some spots in single digits, Kevin.
Yeah, and there were some spots out west and up north that again for the fourth straight morning actually fell below zero. And we are setting up a day today where temperatures get back into the 30s. A lot of areas above 32, which is the first time we've done that in a while. And it will be with a mixture of sunshine and clouds and a much lighter wind. So if you're going to be outdoors for any length of time, there will be a slight breeze, but it won't be one to add a significant bite to the air for a good part of the day. Temperatures in the 30s for the most part this afternoon, and in the 30s is the bare minimum for us for most of this week. It does not mean we won't have several systems to contend with, most of which will be quick moving and not have a lot of moisture with them. Maybe a few flurries tonight up north. Tomorrow again, we start with sunshine. We add clouds and a little bit of light snow starts to push into southwestern areas of the state very late in the day. That'll be around tomorrow night and first thing Wednesday morning. If we're going to have a somewhat compromised morning commute, it would be Wednesday morning. Beyond that, even milder air starts to push in behind that system. That means mixed showers later Wednesday night and early Thursday, and likely some rain shower activity Thursday night and into early Friday. So each of those systems provides some milder air. All of that unsettled weather eventually pulls away later on Friday and should set up a decent weekend with temperatures in the 30s to lower 40s. Just have to bear in mind those numbers are going to be a solid 20, 25 degrees higher than we were this past weekend, and probably not providing a much of a wind chill either by the time we get there. That'll be a huge change for us by the time we get down the road there.
Okay, and we are seeing some kind of gray skies out here in Plymouth right now, but flurries again arriving in the afternoon tomorrow.
Yes, and it looks like I think for southwestern areas, you'll have some light snow, kind of a steady light snow developing late in the day. Temperatures will likely be above freezing as that happens, which should help roadway conditions.
Yeah, and really not bad conditions for primary day.
And for most of this week, yeah, we're talking temperatures above average all week. And even as we cool down into the weekend, we're still going to be above the averages for this time of year.
And after those weekend temperatures that we just had, 40s is going to feel very nice.
Very warm.
It will. All right, Kevin, thank you so much. And moving on, an autopsy is scheduled today for a man who died after a shooting involving police in Nashua. Investigators say police were called to a domestic disturbance at a home on Marie Avenue late Saturday night. The caller told police that there was a man with a firearm there. At the scene, there was a confrontation between the man and police. The Attorney General's office says that four officers fired at that man and the man died at the scene. His name has not yet been released. And thank you for joining us for News 9 Plus here on Facebook, X, and YouTube. Have a great day.